My name's Emara. I was born in Cambodia, in Siem Reap. I'm the older in the family of nine. They ring alarm around 5 o'clock. The sun rays come up, we start working. After we finish dinner, they allow us to go work again till midnight or night, 11 or 12 o'clock. And then we come home, sleep, and then 5 o'clock, wake up over and over again. A soldier, Pol Pot soldier, he called me, Emara, your father killed. That time I feel like I don't believe him. He say, if you cry, you gonna die right away too, you know. But that time I don't cry. But after he lies, then I meet my brother. He go from the wallet, go to find me. And then I run from that place, go to the river. That time we don't have Jesus, you know, we just pray to any God. Say, why God, my father died that time because I'm still young. I don't know what's going on yet and my father died. I just sit down and cry about things over and over. They allow the children, all the people work, come home for 3 days. And then I meet with my mom. My mom have the baby that time too, just born 2 days before my father killed. My brother don't have no milk to drink because my mom no milk. And then I just go to the people ask for the sugar to boil with the water and feed him. That time, the Angkor, they told like my age, time to go to be a soldier. If someone married me, maybe you stay home. And that time, my ex-husband, he single too, and then his mom know about that too. And then they discuss with my mom. Angkor told us to stay home 1 day, no work, but another day go back to work. And then we work separate, not work together. When I married, I go live at my mother and Lao side. And then we don't have something to eat. And then my mother in Lao, she have a potato. And she cook potato in the bullet case. When I go close to pick it up, pull it up, and then they blow up the water all over to my body. See this from the company. The burn all over from my body. We heard that my brother-in-law, like Thai, you know, Thai and Thang, he live in the United States. And then that time he find the family, find out where his family live or his family alive. I feel like scared, you know. My baby no meal, it all like my mom had to. when I have fever and then sick. I saw many Christian people go to Thailand to announce the good news. And that time I don't believe in Jesus Christ, but I hear the word. I listen to them, they got so loved the world and come to the earth and born with the Mary. I heard from that thing in the camp, but I not get it. But when I came to the United States, I heard the people translate at the first church at Pearl Street in at Berlin, you know. That time Clay and he sponsored me and bring me to church. I try to open the Bible, read, and after that I know Jesus. Time I think 9 years, 8 years, I already followed, have my grandma carry the food to the temple for the monk. A lot of God, you know, like fish, toro, the idol, a lot of things, you know, and then they say that one the God of love in Cambodian, God of love. I say, why God of love is so skinny? My grandma say, God of love, they have the mark in on the hand, and the God of love have a mark on the leg, and the God of love have something mark on the under the knee. Every day my grandma say that one the God love, wait for that God. I think that time all the Christian come to help the refugee and help us to understand how to living in the United States. And after I believe in Jesus Christ, that time I have a problem with the family, with my ex-husband and the children. He leave me when I got divorced. I just lonely. I watch TV and television. I saw the Christian people go to mission in Africa or somewhere that I always watch a channel, a Christian, about the mission. Then I just saw that I feel like, oh God, I want to do a mission like the people, but I don't speak English. I cannot do anything because the money I don't have, you know, like I think like that. And I just pray. And after that, I meet my husband, you. And then first time he said he not a Christian too, you know, just pray to God and say, God, he the right one, or I don't know, but I need someone help me too, because now I live alone and I work two jobs. I don't have enough money to pay all the things. After that I pray, and then God answer, he the right person to me. So happy when he say he want to be a ministry and want to go to school to be a pastor. Like the first time he want go to the Guatemala, something like that. And the ticket cancel and then go to Cambodia. When I met it, we always say together, we don't want to go Cambodia. I go missing, go somewhere, no Cambodia, just say that. But God answer us, go to back to Cambodia. Because I told God I'm not speak English. And then you have to speak your own language, go to Cambodian. That's why that I think in my mind, oh, God is so good to me. God called me to do his work. God know I speak my own language. They send me to Cambodian. Then God answer me more than I thought. So amazing that I believe in Jesus Christ, you know. All everything that we never thought, but God make all happen.